Hello, Tacticians. I'm Nicholas, game designer on Lord of the Rings Rise to War, and I'm back with you today for a new episode of Devs in the Tavern. Many new changes will be coming to Middle-earth with new seasons. That is why today we will check out what seasons are all about. Seasons in Lord of the Rings Rise to War are scenarios experienced by players that last about 2 to 3 months. Players have to go through season 1 to reach season 2, so which means that brand new players will not cross paths with experienced ones. Seasons provide different experience every time, which means new content, new features, new rules. It's an opportunity for players to start over, maybe choose another faction, and have another shot at winning. So once a server is deemed ready based on the season goals progress, its players are eligible to start new seasons. We wait until enough players from multiple servers are ready, and then we merge the server together to start the new season. So the goal of merging servers for a new season is to group the most active players together for an exciting experience. Before the server merges, you will be able to save the Fellowship or Warband chat as a friends group chat, as well as keeping your friend list, which means that if you so wish, you can play with those people again in the new season. In the case of season 1 and 2, players who were in the same server previously will also be in the new season server, so you will be able to meet the same people. Everything related to equipment and commanders will be retained across seasons, which means that equipment themselves will be retained, equipment fragments, and for example, if you have upgraded any equipment, this also is saved across seasons. Commanders' levels are reset, but the commanders that you have unlocked will be retained across seasons, and any progress towards their respect as well. This also includes commanders that you have not recruited yet. So for example, if you have 500 respect towards recruiting Gandalf, this is saved across seasons. Commanders' gifts, the items that you can give to commander to increase their respects, those will also be retained across seasons. Items that are not marked as seasonal will be kept across seasons. Those specific items, you can recognize them because they have a little clock icon on them. The Mathem medals and gems are also saved across seasons. The resources that you can use in your settlements are not kept, as well as the settlement progress, so the buildings that you built, for example, and the tiles that you captured on the map. The ring progress also is not saved and will have to start from scratch. This part is what you will be able to experience from scratch in the new season. The server progression will also be reset because it depends on the player progression on the map. So it's like taking your commanders, equipment, mathem medals, and gems, and moving to a new place. If you want to see a detailed list of those rules, I encourage you to check out the article shared on our socials. So in new seasons, the basics of the gameplay will still be retained. Players will still want to expand, capture more tiles to get more resources for reaching further objectives, capturing control points for the factions. But with every new season will come new rules that will change the way that the game is played. And in some cases, maybe even new season goals. That's depending on what the theme of that season is. As such, by recruiting more commanders, upgrading them, unlocking all their skills, collecting more equipment of higher rarity, upgrading it as well, this will be the progress for the long term, and it will help players get the best start in every season. We have had a lot of questions asked by players on Discord. Here I have some of them, and I will answer them today. Let's see what we have. Oh. This question comes from Swampert. Will you change geographic layout of the map at all, or map aesthetics? Oop, let me put it back. So the map itself is the map of Middle-earth, so we cannot change this. We will use the map that Tolkien himself drew in later seasons, yes. But what we can change is how the map interacts with the players. So for example, what are the most important control points? What are the objectives on the map? The placement of the neutral camps for recruiting neutral units. Those things we will be able to change in the future seasons, and we will. All right, next one. This one comes from Namzak. Will there be new mechanics corresponding to battles? So I assume Namzak is referring to what happens in the battle, so commanders, units. We will definitely have new units and new commanders coming with the later seasons and as early as season 2. So those commanders and units will have exclusive skills and exclusive traits that they can use in battle or even outside of battles as well. So players will be able to experience this new strategic element going forward. I will pick a last one. Oh, this one is a little bit tough. Okay. This one comes from the player named Goblin Double Clown. What happens to the Red Book of Westmarch in the new season? Do we get a new book with a new set of rewards? So how it works is that the Red Book of Westmarch is based on what happened in the War of the Ring. As you know, it starts at the Shire when Frodo and Sam and the other hobbits exit from the Shire, and it ends at the last battles of the War of the Ring. So actually we cannot continue this story mode, basically. But what we can say is that there will be a new mode coming later. Maybe not exactly at the start of season 2, but we are preparing some new mode that will include some Red Book of Westmarch elements into it with a lot more content to experience. And we hope that the players will be looking forward to it. And as my friend, the time has come. It's the end of today's episode. But if you want to know more, check out our social media and look out for our community events. We will see you in game.